Hey, what's up everybody? Welcome back to another awesome tutorial in Revit Global Knowledge. Today I'm going to show you how to create aspirant stair in Revit, and some more we will add another reinforcement rebar in Revit. I think it would be pretty interesting for this tutorial because you might be need some tip and trick to create your aspirant rebar in Revit. As you can see, here is the rebar that I have created. Once you might be need to create some floor for reference plan first. After that, only you offset until here. Anyway, we will walk through together from start to finish for by placement our rebar. And in this case, we are using for freeform rebar. If you are first time to visiting to my channel or reaching out to my channel, and you didn't know about me yet, my name is Ben from Revit Global Knowledge. I'm going to help you from zero to hero and from beginner level to professional level, and my work is let's grow for future construction together. And okay, anyway, let's stick around together for this tutorial. And again, I just remind you, don't forget to hit subscribe button below and turn on notification for more about Revit, because I make a lot of content about Revit for every week. And I just want to disclaimer my content will be upload every Saturday, but don't worry about that. Sometimes I will add 3 video or 4 video for every week, and sometimes I will post 2 video only, depend on I got more time to do video and I got creative new content to post it out to my channel. And anyway, if you want to learn Revit, you come to the right place. Don't forget to hit subscribe button below and turn on notification for more about Revit. And okay, I think it's I talked too long already. Let's jump into our project together. Here is my previous stair that I created, one with aspirant stair plus reinforcement rebar. So I would like to close this one first. After that, we create a new project and we start walking through together. Control N on my keyboard for new project here. And as you can see, here is a new project panel. We just drop down and finding for we use for reinforcement rebar. So it's better use matrix structural template because we didn't need to load into our rebar shape in our project. Alright, so now I already in my Autodesk Revit structural template. So may I call this one for a few seconds? Okay, I need to save first. Alright. Okay. As a default, we are in level 2, but by right, we need to work on level 1. So I just select on level 1 first and close this one first. So as a normal, we need to go to our architecture tab here and create our stair. It's a stair default here, stair 2 here. You just select here like this one and select for the square and stair like this. And you start placing like for the actual runway, I just leave it like this, and for actual creative, I just leave it like this. If you want to change, you can change it by yourself because I just give you a concept. But if you follow from start to finish, you will know how to create that easier for you. Just a quick tutorial only. I just take something like this, yeah, something like this, and this one, so this one. Okay, something like this. So we just hit finish first. Let's go to our 3D default here. Okay, as you can see now, here it's nothing, but don't worry about that because I know what's going on. You just go typing on your keyboard VG for visibility graphic, drop down finding for stair because I was there unchecked. This one you just check here, hit apply, then hit okay. Okay, so now we got our square stair something like this, but I want to change my stair first, change it to something like okay, this one cast in place stair. Processing is regenerating. Okay, this one, don't worry about that. So we need to create our floor first for reference stair. Go to my level 1 here again. Then I'm going to my architecture tab as a normal, finding for floor, just like here one, then use a pick line. I'm going to start to pick something like this and pick here as well and describe as well. And describe as well. Hit escape a couple of times. Let me take a look. Is this everything is fine? Then we just click through together. Okay, so now everything is fine. We just click finish first. I'm going back to my 3D here. See what happened. So this one is too thickness. So I'm going to change first. Duplicate that. Change that for 15 millimeter, okay, 100 millimeter. This one you might be need to change as well because the top one we rename only. Okay, so now we need to modify sharp element first because we need to upset this one, just like your floor like this, then modify sharp element. Hit escape a couple of times. I need to edit first. Just I'm going to my top here like this one, then selecting my floor like this. I need to edit this boundary first. I'm going to trade down something like this. Yeah, and here trade down something like this. Closely a bit. Okay, this one we need to move also, make sure everything is correct position. All right, and me tell this one, you need to extend TR on your keyboard, on my keyboard, for trim and extend something like this. I'm going to start from top view. Okay, the reason why I edit my floor here because when I placing my freeform rebar here, I don't want to my rebar overlap until here, something like this. This is the reason. So I just hit finish. Everything is okay already, and I need to open for my sound elevation here because I need to give a dimension. Go to no elevation. Let me take a look. Okay, I don't know which is one. Which one is correct? Yeah, this one. So I just clock the view elevation first, and the railing here. Okay, we just do it like this. The eye on my keyboard for dimension start from here until here, 2446. No, now I know already. You might need to remember that. Go to my 3D here again. Select here again. Start from here. Modify sub element, select this one. Okay, I forgot already. 2446. And another guy, this one, don't worry about that. Okay, what happened? 2446. Delete dimension. Yep, no worried about that. Just like the corner here, something like this. Two, four, six. Hit enter. Okay, good. Perfect. As you can see, everything is perfect. So now we just hit escape a couple of times because everything is perfect. As you can see, our floor is running properly, coming something like this. It's time to add our reinforcement, which is on my keyboard for visibly graphic. I need to turn off my stair first. Easier for me placing my rebar here. Like this one, apply it. Okay. Go to my structure here, finding for rebar tab, just hit OK first. And then we would like to use for, align tool first, just for align. And this one I'm going to place for the bottom one. Okay, sorry. I just like my stair again. Okay, the reason why I cannot place my rebar because I never check for structural here. Make sure check for structural here. The only Revit allows you to add the rebar there. So I'm going to click rebar again. This one is, I'm okay with that. Use align tool. We start from the bottom one because we want our rebar running from bottom. If you didn't know yet about freeform rebar, you can check that. I will put link in description. I make a lot of content about reinforcement rebar. You can just take a look and you can take a look and combination those tutorial for create your whole project with structure in Revit. Okay, so now I place already for bottom one, so I need to change my layout first. I want to change it for fixed number, change it for 10 and use a pad here. We press from bottom also, from this side also, like this one. Then you just hit okay for my rebar here. I change it to 10 mm. And if you didn't know about how to create a rebar size, I will put link in description also. It's my previous tutorial. I just hit finish one. Alright. Okay, this one. Actually, this one I want more. Hit escape first, just like here, something like 50. Yeah, get it's perfect. So now I want to add for vertical here, something like this first. By add that, you need to select your stair again. Let me override for graphic first. You can change whatever you want and make sure this for pattern background here you change to solid, and this one I'm going to change it to red color. I think green is better. Yep, go to my visibility stat here, turn on for view as a solid. It's okay, and this one change to fine again. Go to rebar again. In the case, I prefer to use surface here. And surface, I start from the bottom one. For start surface and end surface, make sure this sphere, this one is constant or same as direction. Sorry, let me tell again. Go to rebar. Surface, start from the bottom one like this. Start surface, make sure this one is constant with another side or same direction. Start and surface here also. Okay, and for layout here, I'm going to change it to fixed number and give it, I think 10 is enough. Yeah, so now we just hit finish. And this one I'm going to override graphic also. Hit escape a couple times. Select this one. Right click on my cursor here. Go to override graphic here by element. And then change this one to solid. We're using for red color. Change this one to fine again. Okay, we need to turn off for view visibility stat first. And boom, you just finish your reinforcement rebar with your spiral staircase. I'm going to my VG here for turn on my staircase here. Okay, where is my staircase? All right, there. Change this one to hidden line. Okay, so as you can see, you finish your spiral stair here already, complete with your reinforcement staircase from the bottom one. And this is how you can use your freeform rebar. I think in the next tutorial, we're adding for floating rebar Stair as well, because it might be interesting, because you might be need something to create that. Anyway, it's pretty much for this tutorial, and I hope you got learn new more about reinforcement rebar. It's not a struggling to create. You might be need to buy plugin to use for your rebar, your reinforcement rebar in Revit, because in as a default Revit got an extra awesome for rebar here. If you know that, you will be easier for use that. Okay guys, it's pretty much for this tutorial, and thank you for watching from start to finish. I see you for another tutorial. For that, I would like to ask you, if you like this video, don't forget hit subscribe button below, like and share. Your like and your subscriber is motivate me to do more content about Revit. Thank you guys, we will build a community together for Revit. Thank you. I see you for another tutorial and have a nice day.